Okay, just keep it on him or what? Okay.
What I'd like to ask, sir, is why are you a Muslim?
Thank you very much for your question. You ask me why am I a Muslim? And the reason is, there are so many reasons. One of the reasons why I'm a Muslim is, when I read the Quran in Surah Ali Imran,
everything I say is
the family of Imran. Surah chapter number 3, ayah verse number 19.
Yes.
Allah tells us, Inna Deena Inda Allah Islam. True faith, true belief is Islam.
Okay. We believe that Jesus Christ, John the Baptist said, Behold the Lamb of God that takes away the sin of the world. Isaiah 53 says, He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon Him, and by His stripes we are healed. We believe that we are saved by believing in Jesus Christ as our sacrifice. How do you get saved in Islam? How do you become a Muslim in Islam?
How does a person become a Muslim? Simple. A person can become Muslim.
Jesus is preaching here.
By the belief, La ilaha illallah. There is no God but Allah. Muhammadur Rasulullah. Muhammad, peace be upon him, is the messenger, is the prophet of Allah.
So why is Muhammad the true prophet?
Muhammad, peace be upon him, was a true prophet, and he was the last of all the prophets. Who was Muhammad, peace be upon him? As far as Jesus is concerned,
life in himself.
Allah tells us
the Son to have life in
our Quran,
and He has given him authority to execute
Jesus because was Isa was a prophet. So we Muslims believe he was a prophet. In our Quran, it tells us that Maryam was the mother of Isa Jesus. We believe that. In our Quran, it tells us that Isa Jesus was not God. So we believe that Isa Jesus, he was a prophet, not God. And lastly, in our Quran, Allah tells us that Isa Jesus, he was sent to the people of Bani Israel, to the Jews, to the people of Israel. And to finish off, sir, in your Bible, in the Gospel according to Matthew, chapter 15, verse 24, in any Bible, Jesus is quoted as saying, I was sent to the lost sheep of Israel. Your turn.
Jay, have you got that?
You know Israel?
Have you got the lost sheep of Israel?
You know Israel?
Have you got it, yeah?
You know Israel?
Yes.
Israel is the name Nabi Allah Yaqub.
We've researched this, by the way.
Israel is the name Yaqub. Okay. You understand? You don't
give. Okay, so God bless you.
That's heaven.
When Jesus came to the lost sheep of Israel, we don't disagree with that, but there are many scriptures that show that he not only came for Israel, but he came for other people as well. In Hosea chapter 2, 23, God desires mercy for all. Isaiah chapter 56, salvation for Gentiles. In Matthew 28, 16 to 20, Jesus said, go into all the world and make disciples, not just to the Jews, but to the Gentiles. So he did come for the Israelites, but there are scriptures that show that not only the Israelites, the message was not just for Israel, but for the Gentiles. But I just want to read a few verses from the Quran. It says in the Quran, Surah 3, verse 3, Surah 2, 101, and 323. Those verses talk about the scriptures in the Torah and the Injil have been corrupted. is. But then you have in Surah 5, 44, Surah 21, 48, Surah 2, 8 to 7, Surah 5, 46, Surah 28, 43, says that the Torah is a guidance to mankind. So how can you have in the same scripture in the Quran and say that the Torah and the Injil have been corrupted, and yet at the same time say that they're guidance and light? How can you have both?
I'll tell you what. As Muslims, we believe there are four books of Revelation. First is the Torah revealed to the Prophet Musa, Moses, peace be upon him. The second book of Revelation is the Zabur, the Psalms revealed upon the Prophet King Dawood, David, peace be upon him. And the third revelation is the Injil, not the Bible, Injil revealed to the Prophet Isa, Jesus, peace be upon him.
Injil means Bible in Arabic.
Quran, the fourth and last book of Revelation revealed to the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Sir, I gave you an example that in our Quran, Allah tells us, Isa, Jesus, he was sent to the people of Israel.
Yeah, but they rejected him.
Sir, to his own people. And I gave you an example that in your Bible, Jesus is quoted as saying, what Allah tells us in the Quran, it says in the Bible, Jesus is quoted as saying in the Bible, in the Gospel according to Matthew, chapter 15, ayah, verse 24. Jesus said, I was sent only, the word only in English, only to the lost sheep of Israel. So when Jesus says, I was sent only to the lost sheep of Israel, it doesn't mean he was sent to the North Americas. It doesn't mean Jesus, he was sent to the South Americas. It doesn't mean Jesus was sent to the Africans. It doesn't mean that Jesus was sent to the Europeans. It doesn't mean that Jesus was sent to the Australians. It doesn't mean that Jesus was sent to the whole of Asia. But in the language, through the mouth of Jesus, in the Christian Bible, Jesus said, I was sent only to the lost sheep of Israel.
Okay. I hear what you're saying, but in that same book, in the last chapter, 28, it says, go into all the world. In John chapter 3, verse 16, it says this. It says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten, let me finish, he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes on him shall not perish but have everlasting life. Also in the Old Testament, Jonah did not go to Israel but to the Ninevites. Ruth, we have a whole book, she was not a Jew, but she was from Moab. And then we have Rahab, who was a prostitute but not a Jew in the Old Testament. So it shows that God was for the Jews but also for non-Jews as well. I want to read this scripture to you, and I want to ask a question, two questions, sir.
Before you ask me, I have a question.
And you are very kind, sir, and I really appreciate it. My question is this. In Isaiah 53, it says, but he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed. All we like sheep have gone astray. We have turned every one to his own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. Here's two questions. One, who is Isaiah speaking about when he says he was bruised for our iniquities? The chastisement of our peace was upon him. By his stripes we are healed. And number two, did Jesus die on the cross?
When we Muslims, we read our Quran, it tells us Isa, he never died.
Okay?
But we Muslims, we believe that despite the fact that we say Isa alayhi salam was a prophet. So we Muslims believe. So we Muslims. Come on. So we Muslims. So we Muslims, we believe. So we Muslims, we believe Isa, Jesus was a prophet, not God. Sir, you believe that Jesus was God, yes?
Yeah.
Right. Can I ask you about being God? Now, we believe Isa was a prophet, and as Muslims, we believe that Maryam, Mary, was the mother of Isa, Jesus. Now, sir, you believe that Jesus was God. My question to you is this: if Jesus was God, was Mary the mother of Jesus?
Mary was the mother of Jesus, yes.
Right. Now, did Jesus create Mary?
Yes.
Jesus is alive.
Was Jesus the baby son of Mary?
Yes.
Was Jesus, thank you very much, was Jesus the creator of Mary?
We've got to define Jesus. Let me ask you a question. You've asked four questions, let me answer it. Let me answer it. In Isaiah chapter 9, it says about the virgin birth. It says, his name, the baby Jesus, his name shall be Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Prince of Peace. So the Old Testament prophesied that God would be born in a baby. Number two, the Quran, many believe, is eternal, the Word. And the Word became paper. The Word went through Gabriel, Abraham, and then it went to become a Quran, paper. Right? That's what many believe. The eternal Word became paper. We're saying the eternal Word, Jesus, became a man. Now, when you talk about, is Jesus God, and how can God be a baby, right? You've got to understand that we believe that God, that Jesus is God and man, two natures in one person. And it says in 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 16, it says this: great is the mystery of godliness, that God is manifested in the flesh. Notice this: great is the mystery of godliness, that God is manifested in the flesh. It's a mystery. And finally, in the Quran, it says our Trinity is Father, Son, and Mary. We don't believe that as a Trinity.
The Trinity
is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
In the Quran, sir.
I'll let you have the last point.
Not Trinity. Let me tell you.
I'll let you have the last point, and then we'll shake hands. Yeah?
Sir, okay. Sir.
You cannot see the kingdom of God.
You said, sir, I ask you a question, is Jesus the son of Mary? You said yes. I ask you a question, did Jesus create Mary? You said yes. I want to ask you another question, did Jesus grow up?
Yes.
Does God grow up?
No. Let me finish. My friend, if an atheist came to you and said, the Quran teaches violence, right? Listen, and brought one verse. If an atheist came to you and said, the Quran teaches violence, and showed one verse or two verses, you say, no, let's look at all the verses. And what Muslims do is say these trick questions and then bring up one or two verses. But you've got to look at all the verses. We believe, just as you, that Jesus is a man. He grew up and he had knowledge as a man, right? But we also believe we have scriptures which show that he was God. For example, John chapter 1 verse 1. In the beginning was the Word was with God, and the Word was God, and the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. Yeah. In John chapter 1 verse 14. Philippians chapter 2, it says this: he thought it not robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation and humbled himself and became a servant. So he's God, but he becomes a servant. And as he became a servant, he humbled himself and his glory was hid. But he was a man, and he was growing as a man. And we said there's a mystery there. You can put these trick questions.
Miracle, isn't it?
And everybody said, yeah, he's got him. No,
miracle.
It's a mystery. It's beyond our mind. Okay, it's beyond our mind. Now I'm going to stop, and I'm going to give you the last word, and then we can shake hands.
Okay.
So we show people that we're not hiding from each other. Yeah? So you can finish, but don't go too long, because you're going to have more time.
So
I'll let you finish it.
When we Muslims read the Bible, and we read verses like this. For example, when people, we Muslims, we say Allah, Arabic it means the God. We say Allah knows everything. But sir, you tell us that Jesus is God. If Jesus was God, then my question is this. I will read to you a verse from your Bible. Then I will ask you a question. Now, sir, in your Bible, in the Gospel according to Matthew, chapter 24, verse 36, Jesus is quoted as saying, in the Bible, Jesus says, no one knows about that day or hour, not even the angels in heaven, nor the Son,
Jesus Christ, because he loves
you. The last day,
Jesus
doesn't know the last day, the day of Qiyamah. Now, we say Allah knows everything. Why is Creator? If Jesus, Son, was God, why didn't Jesus know the last hour?
Allah, can I explain it to you? Yeah, you're a very clever guy. Yeah?
Clever, I'm a Muslim.
In weddings, the father had the prerogative to announce the wedding. On the wedding day, it was the father's right to announce the wedding. The Greek word for know is not the word know as in knowledge. It means the person has the right to announce, okay? So if you look at it, study it, in the culture of the Jewish people, the father has the right to announce the wedding. That's what it's all about there. And if you don't believe me, read the context, and it's about the wedding context. He uses wedding context about the virgins and all the rest of it. But let me just finish here. In Matthew chapter 2, verse 10-12, the wise men worshipped him at his birth. In Matthew 8:2, the leper worshipped him when he healed him. In Matthew 9:18, the young ruler worshipped him. In Matthew 14:32, the disciples worshipped him. In Matthew 20:20, the mother of James and John worshipped him. In John 9:35, the blind man worshipped him. He's worship. If he was a prophet, why is he accepting worship?
Can I? Thank you very much.
Good point.
Sir!
I wanted to stop, but you put me on
the... Carry on, sir! You just told us that Jesus was worship. You are trying to tell us that Jesus was God.
Yeah.
Let me ask you, sir, when we read any Bible, whether it's the Orthodox Bible with 81 books or the Catholic Bible with 73 books or the